Hello everybody, and welcome back to an extremely special unboxing today that I am pretty goddamn excited about. So without further ado, let me just open up this box and let me unveil what is inside this enormous package. Here she is, if I can get into it. Just open up the flap like that. And there she is. The absolute beauty that she is.
So yes, today I shall be unboxing this epic, jaw-dropping, 7-disc vinyl set of the original soundtrack to the Daleks Master Plan. The vinyl set itself comes with 7 discs and a paperback booklet. The main master plan arc is etched to discs through to 7, with the first being a single-sided disc with Mission to the Unknown on side A, with a TARDIS etching on the B side, the discs of which are on a translucent blue vinyl. However, that is not what I'll be unboxing today. There is also a limited to only 1,000 copies Amazon exclusive edition set, which comes on an epic orange and white splatter variant, which I'm just going to call the Pirate Flame variant, with a Dalek etching on the B side of the Mission to the Unknown disc. This is a set that I probably won't listen to at all, if I'm honest. Oh, why spend £100 on it then? I detail this a bit more in my review of The End of the World. In my view, 60s era Doctor Who is the best. The Daleks Master Plan, The End of the World and Fury from the Deep are the three kings of representing 60s era Doctor Who and my opinions on it. And in my view, this set is the ultimate way to celebrate not only one of the greatest 60s era Doctor Who stories of all time, not only one of the greatest Dalek stories, but one of the most ambitious Doctor Who stories of all time. But enough with the introductions, let us take a look and review this absolute beauty of a set. I think I can just about fit it into frame, as this is a really, really, really big box set, as you can tell. Super thick spines and whatnot, as you can see. But yeah, here we go. Let me just take off the shrink wrap first of all. The presentation of this box set, and it should be noted that this is a vinyl box set, of which comes in like a lidded box, and the records themselves don't slide out of the side of the box like some record box sets do, like this Pink Floyd Pulse box set. So for the sort of artwork presentation of the box set, we have BBC, the new Doctor Who logo, in an embossed sort of silver up at the very top there. If I can get that into frame, there you go. The Daleks Master Plan original BBC TV soundtrack, and then for the sort of cover art itself, it's a very well done and beautiful looking artistic depiction of Operation Inferno from episode 2, and is just a stunning looking cover overall. Just absolutely fantastic and beautiful looking cover. I love the sort of way they've done it, because it looks like just a monochromatic picture, as 60s era Doctor Who was, but they've given it this sort of wash of flame colours in various places to sort of contrast the monochromatic sort of blue and grey nature of the cover. Overall, I guess you would say, with the sort of flames going on in the background with Operation Inferno,
and all of the sort of flames from this pyroflame have sort of been glinted off this Dalek here. And one could sort of nitpick at this cover and say, oh, why does this Dalek have a pyroflame and these two don't? But it's whatever, it's an absolutely fantastic and stunning cover art, and I've got to amend whoever the artist was, or give credit to whoever the artist was, for this absolutely stunning depiction of an amazing Doctor Who scene. For the spine of the box set, we have the BBC Doctor Who logos, the Daleks master plan, Demon Records, and a little code down there. For the top of the box, it is just plain sort of dark navy TARDIS blue, as is the right side of the box, and as is the bottom of the box there. And for the back of the box, we have sort of another stunning bit of artwork by the cover artist, which is the TARDIS sort of looking down on the chaotic, apocalyptic nature of Operation Inferno, with the sort of orange haze of flames in the background, with the sort of jungle and TARDIS there. It's just absolutely fantastic. Then on the right hand side here, we have, written by Terry Nation and Dennis Spooner, starring William Hartnell, with linking narration by Peter Purvis. Then you've got BBC Demon Records, copyright Guff, and then we have barcode here. And it also says, due to the age and nature of the archive material, sound quality may vary. And there we go, there was the exterior presentation of this box set. And then if we were to take the lid off the box set, in the back of the lid is this massive swirling vortex of orange and flames. It looks absolutely fantastic, as you can see there. Then here we have the interior of the box set, or the inner contents of the booklet. And now it should be noted, as I mentioned, there are 7 LPs in this box set, and there's also a paperback booklet to the whole thing. And it also should be noted, and as I will show later on, if you line up all 8 of the 7 record sleeves and a booklet, it will line up and form one picture. I think possibly 2 pictures, or maybe it's just one picture for the exclusive set, which this is, and there's another picture on the standard edition. I haven't looked too much into the standard edition with regards to the differences. All I know is that the etching on disc 1 side B to this is different to that, and the colour is different. That's pretty much what I know. So if we were to take out the booklet, just do this very slightly, as I do not want to tip out the records by accident and they just shatter and I have a very unfortunate time. So let's actually move the box set out of the way for a moment. So we have the booklet here, which is a tad bit thin, which was sort of kind of a little disappointing in a way. But here is part of the artwork. It appears you get both bits of artwork and on the sleeves by the looks of it. So here we go. So there's part of the artwork, which I'll show later on, and then another part of the second bit of artwork, which I'll show later on. And then in the interior of this box set, we have a massive sort of wonderful streaky bit of artwork, which has Doctor Who, the Daleks Master Plan, written by Terry Nation and Dennis Spooner, first broadcast BBC One 9th of October 1965 and 13th of November 1965 through to 29th of January 1966. So there we go. And then you've got a bit about the production, and then here you have
got a huge bit of your huge list of the cast here, and the Doctor is credited to Doctor Who, interestingly enough. But yeah, here we go. Just absolutely fantastic and very well done. It's just a shame they didn't do a little more with the booklet, because this is more of a pamphlet than anything else, which is, you know, a little disappointing in my view, but you know. And now we get on to the records themselves. Let me see here. Oh boy, this is going to be interesting and may take a while, so I'm just sort of going to try and speed through these, as I don't want to take too long with these, as I'm not 100% sure how interesting this bit will be. So for the first record here, sort of, as I said, they sort of all map up the form artwork, as I will show near the end of the video. Spine, Dalek's Master Plan LP1, this contains Mission to the Unknown and the etching. Comes in an interior sleeve, absolutely fantastic artwork once again. And there we go, there's the contents of the disc. Oh my god, that is a sexy piece of vinyl. Whoa. And here is the first record, which looks absolutely fantastic. I was talking in private with Harry Williams Productions the other day, and he said it kind of, the colour variant of this kind of looks like a pizza, and I will kind of agree to that. So yeah, this is the first disc in the box set. Mission to the Unknown is etched to side A, and on the B side of this disc, I don't know how well I'll be able to show this on camera, but I don't know if I could show this at all on camera. I may do an insert later on, but on this side of the vinyl there is a Dalek etching, and on the traditional, or on the standard edition, there is a TARDIS etching to the side of, or to the B side of this disc. Probably going to have to do an insert later on just to show
and
the Dalek.
And here is
on
a
this.
Look at the Dalek etching to the B side of the Mission to the Unknown disc that I just showed. But yeah, on the standard edition, it's a TARDIS etching to the B side of the disc. Here, however, as you can see, it is a Dalek etching, which is exclusive to this particular edition of the vinyl set.
Disc 2, spine, and then the back. Same artwork, and then the contents here. So this is a double-sided disc this time, with the first two episodes of the Daleks Master Plan on it. So, Nightmare Begins. And Day of Armageddon there. So, disc 3 here. Spine. And the back. Again, same artwork on the inner sleeves. Contents on the back there. Devil's Planet. And then the Traitors there. Disc 4 with the front. The spine. And then the back. Inner sleeve. Oh, this is a nice looking one, the disc wise. Episode 5, Counterplot, and 6, Coronas of the Sun. Disc 5, yep, 5. With the inner sleeve once again here.
Feast of Stephen. And then Volcano. Quite fitting actually to have Volcano on this colour variant. Oh, that's interesting. And there's actually a blotch of the colour variant coming through on my label of episode 8 Volcano there, on the sort of label of it there, as you might be able to see just there,
which is quite unusual.
Disc 6 with the front, the spine, and then the back there. Inner sleeve. Episode 9, Golden Death. And then episode 10, Escape Switch. Then we have Disc 7, the best disc of them all, Abandoned Planet and Destruction of Time. Absolutely fantastic set of episodes, even though Day of Armageddon and Mission to the Unknown are stronger episodes, I think this is probably the best sort of two-part moment in the Daleks Master Plan with regards to episodes. So there we go, LP7. And is it going to end on an absolutely beautiful vinyl? I hope so, because these episodes most certainly deserve it. And that's a problem sort of have. The colour hasn't been extremely consistent with the records, I would have said personally. And this sort of follows suit, unfortunately. It sort of dips up and down with regards to, I don't know how you would call it, splatteriness, I guess you would say. The blotches are a lot more prevalent in some records than they are in others, unfortunately. Which, you know, it's still a fucking amazing set, and I admire how this set is constructed, coloured, and artistically put together. It's a beautiful set. And at the bottom, actually, we do have another... Wait a minute. Oh, that's the lid. I'm an absolute idiot. And it should also be noted at the bottom of the box set has the same sort of vortex pattern as the lid did. As I hopefully mentioned previously, if you were to line up all 7 LP sleeves as well as the booklet, on both sides they form 2 gigantic pieces of artwork. So on the front side we have this Dalek here, just sort of overlooking Operation Inferno, as you can see with the orange haze in the background. Then if you were to flip everything over, you then get this wonderful piece of the TARDIS in the Time Vortex with some nice orange swirls sort of thrown into the mix, along with these nice streaks of blue. Very, very nice piece overall, I would have said. And there you go guys, that was my unboxing on the Amazon exclusive, the Daleks Master Plan original soundtrack vinyl. I am so, so happy to have this in my collection, and it is such a great way to celebrate an absolutely incredible Doctor Who story. I just wish there was a limited edition number on it somewhere, so I can tell which one I have out of the 1,000, but you know, still absolutely impressive set overall, and I think this is just an absolutely incredible set to own and have in the collection. I just absolutely love it. So like, favorite, comment, subscribe. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Pitch gold black, dematerializing.